Filipinos are known to be lovers of music, and as a matter of fact, we have produced champions, not just nationally, but internationally as well, bringing home pride and honor to the country. And why is it so for us Filipinos? Stay tuned to Hope Channel in the next 60 minutes as we try to discuss here musicians. I'd like to welcome to the show my guests. I have here teacher Ana Maria de la Fuente. She's actually connected with the College of Music, Lourdes College. Welcome to Dynamic Youth.
Welcome.
Opo. And we have, of course, our sociologist. We have here Ms. Anjali Azcuna Colera. Welcome to Dynamic Youth.
Thank you for having me here, Doc. It's a pleasure.
Yes, and of course, we have a parent, no? And she's Dr. Victoria Estroga. She's the Program Dean, Teacher Education. Magandang araw po sa atin.
Thank you for inviting me to be here.
Oh, po, kasi mamaya kakanta po kayo eh. All right, and of course, kailangan i-welcome ko din ang aking co-host. I have here Jovin Jimenez.
Thank you, Doc. I am so excited, really excited to hear more music talks with our guest resources. Doc?
All right. So, akala ko eh, excited si Jovin to hear the young people of Lourdes College sing and perform for us on TV. Ha? So, simulan na natin ngayon. Unahin natin si Teacher Ana. Teacher Ana, how many years have you been involved in the music industry as a teacher, as a coach, and everything else?
Teacher, I have been teaching for more than 20 years. And at the same time, I have been coaching.
So, medyo matagal na po yun. Kung baga, eh, we know already that you are one of the pillars of music in Region 10, no? And recognized nationally also. So, tanungin natin ngayon ang ating sociologist, si Angie. Angie, meron palang tinatawag na music culture. Bakit ang mga Pinoy eh, mukhang very renowned on this?
Music in the Philippines is, kasi music in sociology is a form of language. And then, if you trace it back, it's been with us since time immemorial. Because like, stories have been handed down to the generation through forms of music. Kaya may lullaby tayo. Kaya tayo, when the colonizers came, may mga kundiman, uh-huh. Diba, and other forms. It's an expression po kasi, Doc. And I think regardless of nationality and race, music is present in all cultures. Siguro sa Filipinos, it's because we are considered as happy people and we are also expressive. So that's why music is really part in our everyday lives.
Oh, at saka siguro music also can bridge any gap, di ba?
Yes.
Parang kahit sa families,
yes.
Kahit sa paralan, kahit sa workplace, Teacher Ana.
Yes, that's true.
Uh-huh.
If you cannot express it in words, you express it in music.
Uh-huh. Either singing or through an instrument.
Yes.
Uh-huh. So puntahan natin si Mother. Mother, kayo po, eh, ready na po ba? Take it away. Sige po. Sa bahay niyo po ba, meron kayong anak or mga anak who are musically inclined?
I think three of us, me as a mother, my eldest son, and my youngest daughter, uh-huh. Except the father.
Uh-huh. So, ibig sabihin, ha, mamaya hindi na po daw kayo uuwi kasi magagalit na si father dahil hindi niyo siya sinali. But kidding aside, ibig po sabihin nun, mother, eh, the inclination of the child, of your children, to be musically inclined was handed down from you.
Yes, from my mother.
Mm-hmm.
Then to me and to my children.
Is there such a thing, Teacher Ana, as genetically transmitted,
yes.
Musically inclined people?
Yes, that's very possible. If your parents are musicians, most of the time the children are musicians.
But what about those whose parents don't even know how to sing Do Re Mi? And yet they have children who, my goodness, you know, bring in so much, you know, honor to the family through music.
I think it skipped a generation.
Uh-huh.
Maybe the parents don't have it, and then the children suddenly have it.
And do you have classic examples of students like that? Like, have you encountered them na yung mga magulang, napakasintonado naman, sintons eh. Pero bakit yung mga anak ang gagaling?
Yes.
And meron naman din na magagaling talaga yung mga magulang. And it's the other way around, not a child can sing a simple tone.
Yes, that's possible. Because there are some parents, if they feel that they are so strict on themselves because of their music, they do not want their children to have the same experience. So they don't let the children study music like them. But there are also some parents, that two parents are musicians, normally the child or the children are also musicians.
So ganun talaga ang pwedeng mangyari. So heto naman, Angie, how does music per se influence the day-to-day activities of an ordinary Pinoy?
Like, part kasi sa atin, when we were colonized, we have a siesta. And so part of relaxation, we... Like music kasi, it gives a feeling of relaxing, soothing, and your emotion. Whatever your feelings are, you let it out in a form of music. Mm-hmm. Okay, be it by playing an instrument or vocally singing it. So, ganon. Whenever, if you would notice, like, kaya nga tayo may sinasabi na those women who sing while cooking, di daw ma-minyo. Diba? Uh-huh. Or in ana. Like, we Filipinos even joke, like, I don't sing in public, but I sing in the bathroom. So, like, when you wake up, you hear, we play music. I'm not sure, but for me, music is really part of my life. And even if you notice now in this generation, kaya may earphones yan sila, and then there are like studies na that most of the generations are becoming deaf is because they put that earphones and then music na the whole time.
The whole time? Parang so, walang ganun. Break, di ba?
Yes.
Kaya minsan kahit tawagin mo pa, walang naririnig.
Yes po. Ha? And the worst part is, pag pinagalitan, ayun na.
Nakalagay na,
nakalagay
ha?
Nakalagay na siya.
Kaya mga kabataan, tingnan ninyo ha.
Relate sila, Doc.
Reaction. Sila.
Opo.
Kaya may magagandang reaction sila kasi ginagawa nila yun,
yes.
Di ba? So, mother. Kayo naman, mother.
Basically, in our family, everybody is enjoying. Everybody is enjoying. I allow them. They cannot study without music as a background. Me, myself, I cannot work at home without music. Uh-huh. And the father is also going with us, living in, and with us, enjoying with us when we will have that sound. Uh-huh. So I think everybody is enjoying. It's very relieving. If it is Sunday, we play guitar with my daughter, and the son is also having his own. And it is a part of our way of life already at home. Mm-hmm. Even if we'll do many things at home, but there is music as a background.
Mm-hmm. Napakaganda, no? Nung kanyang experience na nire-relate niya, it's a way of life. They find enjoyment doing it together. Di ba, Teacher Anna? I think that's the reason why you went into music.
I think so. No, I yes. Uh-huh. My mother used to play piano, so she would go to the piano and then she would play Broadway. And I would just sit there looking at her. And then later on, I took it upon myself just to learn. Everybody can play, but I went further.
Pero kasi, even if you would say na you went further, kung wala yung ano mo, yung passion mo for that, na handed down siguro, because you were brought into this world with music all around you, that must be a great factor already.
It is a very great factor. My father sings, my mother plays the piano. Yeah. My lolo plays the violin. Mm-hmm. So naturally, it came down to us.
So, lahat kayo ngayon are also into some kind of music.
Some kind of music. I'm the only one who plays now, but the rest, they sing.
All right. So, what about it, Angie? So, it's handed down from generation to generation. Is it then a wonder na ang mga Pinoy will always be known for their love of music?
Yes. Let me just share this, Doc. There's a theory in sociology, differential association theory. Once you're exposed to that kind of environment, like the case nila ni Doc, the case nila ni Teacher Anna, they're exposed to it. That's why the legacy, kumbaga, of music is continued on, is passed on through generations. So, yun siya. Because of that, and then music is an expression, so it's an art per se. Ang culture kasi ng Filipino is very rich. Somehow, and we are so attuned to our emotion. That's why across countries, ang Pinoy talaga nag-excel. Yeah. For somehow,
di
ba?
Is there such a thing, Teacher Anna, being there as a teacher, as a mentor, as a coach, is there such a thing as a prerequisite for somebody to be, you know, enrolled in your class or in your whatever it is in your studio para maging successful siya. Or there is no prerequisite at all. Anybody, any age can just come to you and learn something from it.
Anybody can just learn. Okay. Uh-huh. But then if you don't have the passion, if you don't have the drive to do more, then nothing will happen to you.
So para bang pabalik-balik ng Doremi lang.
Yes, pabalik-balik lang. And then especially...
So what's lacking in that?
Ano? The discipline.
The discipline. So kailangan mo pala, aside sa passion, kailangan yung discipline.
You need the discipline. How will you practice if you don't have the discipline? Especially if you're a music student, if the teacher says you practice this, you have to practice that, or else in the next lesson, you cannot go ahead.
And would you know if your student is practicing or not?
Yes.
So hindi pwedeng dayain.
Hindi pwedeng dayain. I know right away, and then I said, you did not practice, no. Yes, ma'am.
But you know, studies have shown, in the medicals, on the medical side, no, studies have shown that young people who are into music, because they're disciplined and coordinated, diba, they actually make better in whatever they put their hands into. In other words, kung sila gustong maging ganitong profession nila, they become more successful because of their training in music. Well, would you say na it does have an effect?
It does have an effect. We call that the Mozart effect. Mm-hmm. There are some pregnant women, when there's the baby still there, they play classical music. So that when the baby is born, the baby has an inclination towards music, and then the baby thinks more than the usual student who does not or who did not have that kind of experience.
So tip sa mga gustong maging nanay, ha? Kailangan lagyan ninyo yan. Para maging, okay, our mother here is so, you know, passionate about it that she wants to share something. Yes.
Yeah, I experienced that one, Doc. The two children I have, no? It was an instruction of my mother. If you want your children to become good singers someday, put a cassette. Musical cassette
nung
on your
cassette
side
pa yan.
From three months up to nine. Uh-huh. And I did it. And really, I experimented that one. Originally, my father and mother, they were not singers.
Mother, akala ko magaling kayong kumanta.
The mother only, but the father not also. Pero during pregnancy, I believe, it really happened to me, no? Putting cassette near to my tummy here, up to 9 months. You cannot just imagine a 1 year old or 2 years old or 3 years old having a stage show that he really wanted to sing. That's why that was also the time that I bought karaoke for him, 3 years old, and he rendered one song on stage when he was kinder two.
So that's amazing, Teacher Anna. No? So how do you, she as a parent, you as a teacher, how do you now try to inspire these children, these young minds, to be, you know, go ahead with what you have, especially in developing your talent in music?
You expose them to more music, especially live performances. It makes a lot of difference than just listening to the CD or the radio. Live performances, that's the best experience.
Mm-hmm. And put them on recitals?
Yes. Recitals.
So, Angie, narinig mo silang dalawa, no? It's so kind of inspiring how they are able to do this para ma-inspire yung mga kabataan. But the thing there that I'd like to ask you, paano yun? Can they actually make a career out of the music that they make?
Okay, career, yes. Profession, unfortunately, in the Philippine setting, music industry is not seen as a profession. Mm-hmm. Correct me, Teacher Anna, ha? But yeah. Per study, it's like an observation, it's like that. But career, yes. Kasi innate na sa atin siya, Filipinos. And I just would like to continue on what Doc mentioned earlier. Kasi it, like what you mentioned also earlier, Doc, about like, when you let the child listen and those musically inclined, kasi there's this brain, sa ating brain na stimulate. Actually, when a child ventures into that, it gives the child another responsibility. That's why they're way ahead of their generation. Kasi they have the passion, they have the drive, they have the motivation, and they have this urgency na ma-perfect ko to dapat apart from what they're doing. So like, for parents, I would recommend that let the child, like, go on, ipa-explore mo yan siya. Because like, you're giving that child, you're expanding his horizon, you're giving that child the responsibility na.
And the opportunity also.
Yes,
the opportunity. So Teacher Anna, what is more fulfilling to you? Seeing a protege, somebody who is extraordinarily magaling, dumating sa inyong studio or sa inyong class, and you're able to develop further, no? O kaya yung isang taong alam mo na parabang napaka-hopeless case naman ito, kahit anong gawin ko yata, and yet would excel somehow.
It is more fulfilling for that hopeless, okay? Because of the effort that you made to encourage, and then finally nakasucceed. That is far greater than having a protege na who can just do it as easy as anybody.
So kumbaga, effortless lang dun sa isa.
Effortless.
Pero yung isa ay kailangan talagang, kumbaga,
blood, sweat, and tears.
Blood, sweat, and tears. Okay. Kayo naman, mother. Eh, paano yun? Eh, yung mga anak niyo musically inclined, how would you feel if they tell you, Mom, I'd like to pursue this because this is what I want to do, and you know, sabi nga eh, ang mga artists daw dito sa Philippines, they're not doing very well economically. We're talking about the practicality of it all. So how would you take it, and would you still go and support your child for this?
Actually, their priority is more on their academic. When they were high school, they first intended to enroll piano, but because they did not like the schedule, it was on a Saturday, so they did not enroll. They only enjoy attending, joining the choral, joining cultural shows where there are musical presentations, and they were members of the glee club when they were elementary and high school.
So now, what are they into?
They are the work. One is working, one is schooling. They focus more on academic.
Not music, per
se. Not music.
But music is their passion.
Yes.
So maganda naman pala kung pwede mo namang i-bridge yung gap na yun.
Yes, Doc. Pwede siya. Because it will always be there. Like, nandyan na yan eh. It's just a matter of like tickling kasi lalabas din yan siya eventually. Like, for the moment, siguro ibalim. Because, as I mentioned, unfortunately, unless you'd become like Leia Salonga, Apple Diab. Because like, the culture of the Filipino is like, dun pa din, Western looking pa din, the colonial mentality is still there. Unless you have been like Charisse Pimpenko na na-broken mo yung ano, when you got back to the Philippines, then you'd be like huge superstar. Kaya nga, this week is considered as the OPM week.
Yes.
Because there is the need na i-revive ang Filipino music. Because admit it, younger generation, we'd rather be like a believer, diba? Taylor Swift, rather Ariana than, Grande, o ganun.
No, sa,
kilala niyo si, diba? Gary Valenciano. Sino siya? May ganun.
Okay, we'll take a very short break. And when we return, we will further discuss our episode here in Lourdes College on music. Please stay tuned.
Filipinos are known to be great lovers of music, may it be pop, classical, ballad, or jazz. Young Filipinos are endowed with such a great talent that is unique among all. Dynamic Youth Students of Lourdes College is now ready to answer the question, how music affects your life.
What is the effect of music in your life?
The effect of music in my life, it serves as my stress reliever whenever I am sad. I can express it through music, by playing the guitar, which is one of my passion and my hobby. And then it is one way to express myself, especially when I can't tell it verbally in action, with action. Through music, I can express all my feelings.
The effect of music in my life is through relating it to my experiences, and it helps me overcome my emotions.
For me, I really love music because sa akin lang, gusto ko rin yung pagsasayaw. Kaya music, isa yun sa paraan ko para ma-relieve yung stress ko, especially dito sa school. Yun yung nakikita kong importance ng music sa akin pang pa-relieve ng stress.
Well, I must say that we all need music in our life. Its melodies bring back the pieces of a broken soul. This is Shireen Gay Bestlet for the episode Melody of Life here in Dynamic Youth.
Welcome to Dynamic Youth. We're still here at Lourdes College together with this beautiful and handsome gentleman with me here in this studio. Now, lately we have discussed earlier about music. And laking paghihinayang ko because my mother never put a cassette with her. That's why I'm like this right now. Don't know how to sing. But, okay, I have here a trivia. Did you know that an 11-year-old boy named Curtis Elton from Trinity College of London has become the youngest person in the world to get a degree of music? Wow, 11 years old. Okay, 11 years old. Who among you here is 11 years old? Okay, anybody? Okay, no. Okay, before we proceed, I have here some questions for our live audiences, okay? So I'm going to ask, first question, how would you describe a musician? Will you be able to identify them among the crowd if you see one? Okay, so I'll be asking from here in the front row, okay? Let me ask first, atong unahon ni si ma'am, can you please stand? Okay, please stand, please. Okay, what's your name?
Jaira.
Jaira, okay. Jaira, are you a music teacher, a music student?
Yes.
Okay, music student, not teacher. Okay, everybody. So, the question, how would you describe a musician and how can you identify him?
For me, we can say that a person is musically inclined because musicians tend to be more sensitive when it comes to music because we are more exposed to basic theories and stuff. Then sometimes pag kahit walang music, we tend to snap our hands, tap our feet, na kahit walang music, parang inside our mind, we're singing or we're listening to certain music or song.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Jaira. But natingala ko because I am sensitive, but I am not music-oriented person. Okay, that's just it. Okay, let me ask the person, this lady beside her, could you please stand? Okay, what's your name?
Hazel, sir.
Hazel, okay. Hazel, you're also a music student.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, how can you describe a musician and how will you be able to know in the crowd whether he is a musician or not?
Well, actually, just like Ate Jaira said, no, so musicians are very sensitive when it comes to music. But also, musicians are very, very playful. So, like, they do something shaking in hands, tapping or snapping, like Ate Jaira said. So that's how we can identify a musician. So that's it.
Okay, thank you, Hazel. Pero murag tanan characteristics silang giingon, murag nasa ako. Pero still, it doesn't belong, di lang yapon music. Music doesn't like me until now. Okay, next question. In a scale of 1 to 10, 10 being the highest, how would you describe the attractiveness of a musician? How would you describe the attractiveness of a musician? Why do you say so? Let me ask. Okay, this lady here, will you please stand? Okay, how you be able, in a scale of 1 to 10, how would you describe the attractiveness of a musician?
Sir, it would be 9.
Nine?
It's close to 10 because I believe that the musicians may not be all perfect, but
lahat sila ay may kakayahan at talento to sing or to create music na pwede nilang ipakita sa atin.
Okay, through music, they become more attractive.
Yes.
Okay, thank you, thank you. I wish I was a music-oriented person so that I will have a 9 rating. Okay, another, let me have here this lady. Will you please stand? Okay, sa imo ha, from 1 to 10, same question, how would you describe or how would you rate the attractiveness of a musician?
Well, for me, it's 10 because musicians express by playing music, they express their thoughts, their emotions of how they feel, and that makes them more attractive.
Okay. Okay, so you heard them. Now, in this segment, we'll be talking more about musicians. Doc?
Yes, Teacher Anna, I'd like us to welcome also to the show another music instructor. We have here Mr. Stephen Kainia. Welcome to Dynamic Youth po, sir. How long have you been teaching music? It's okay. Go ahead.
Actually, it's been 3 years.
Ah, so baguhan po kayo. Yes. Bagito pa, so to speak. Mm-mm. And pero it is really your choice to go into music teaching.
Accidentally.
Ah, accidental. My goodness. Inamin niya din na kumbaga pinilit lang siya. Ano po bang music instrument ang inyong kinakatuwaan na marunong kayo?
Piano.
Piano. And yes. You also sing.
Not so.
But piano, you piano, do piano.
I used to, yes.
So how come you say po na you are, it was by accident?
Actually, when I graduated about my course, I decided to take music as my hobby. Then after I graduate, then I went to play in the bar. Actually, it's been 2 years. I play casino then. Teaching is not my actually plan. Then it happens that Lourdes College got immediate hiring, so I decided to
try.
Yes.
And how do you find it?
Then eventually I fit myself na pwede pala.
So natuwa na din siya, Teacher Anna, di po ba? So what are the qualities po that one must have in order for one to succeed in pursuing one's passion in music?
Still discipline. Because if you don't have that, you don't find time to do what you're supposed to do. Like for example, if you have an assignment like to arrange, if you don't work on it, nothing will happen to you. Or if you have to finish this book, piano book, at the end of the semester, if you don't take time to practice, you will never be able to do it.
Uh-huh. So, kumbaga, madaling maghanap ng paraan na umiwas.
Yes.
Kaysa yung sundin.
Yes. Especially with high-tech na ngayon. Ay, naku. They would rather play than practice.
Uh-huh.
So if you don't push them and then they don't have that self-discipline, they will never go to the piano and practice.
Uh-huh. So yun, kailangan self-discipline. Pwede may microphone dito sa aking mga music students. I'd like to ask them, yung nasa front, anybody can answer this. How long have you played an instrument or, you know, singing? How long since, how old were you when you had that? Anybody can answer? Yes? All right, sige, please. Yes? How long have you played an instrument or are you into singing instead?
I'm into singing, Mom. I started singing in a choir when I was 12 years old. There from then, dun ko po na realize na yun po yung calling ni God sa akin na dun po ako sa music field. So ngayon po, pinapursue ko po yung passion ko. And I want to share my knowledge to music and to share the word of God through music.
So that's you all. Are into singing.
Yes, Ma'am.
Sino sa inyo ang play an instrument? Yes, what instrument is that?
Actually, Ma'am, I started playing the guitar at the age of 8. And I was taught by my uncle. And then eventually, Ma'am, after I learned to play the guitar, I have also learned how to play the bass guitar, the keyboards, and the drums eventually, Ma'am. So I've been playing those instruments up until now. And I'm developing everything, ma'am, more about music, ma'am.
Okay. Do you have any frustrations that is related to what you have, you know, already planned to do with your life, taking music as a primary course here? Do you get frustrations or wala lang, enjoy lang talaga? Who would like to answer that? Yes? The lady with the mic already on her table.
Frustrations. Of course, as we are students, so we easily get frustrated when, example, we are given a piece and we don't get it right away. So it's very frustrating for us because we have to really give an effort to learn it, to practice it very.
So, ibig sabihin, Teacher Anna, ang gusto yung iparating, effort.
Effort.
So, E means effort para sa kanila. Yes. For them to have an E, which is excellence.
Yes. If they don't exert effort, then they don't get it. Uh-huh. That's what makes them frustrated.
But are musicians, are musically inclined people really, really moody? Not just being sensitive to things around them, but do they also have mood swings? A lot more than the regular general population?
Not really, because if they feel like practicing, then that's the time they practice. Okay, so it's not moody. If you have the discipline, you don't pay attention to your moods. Even if you don't feel good, you have to practice.
Uh-huh.
So you have to forget, okay? Mm-hmm. If you feel bad, you have to forget that because you have to practice.
What about you, Sir Stephen? What is your goal as a musician?
Share music, composing music, that is my goal. And
how do you inspire your students?
Impart about my experience and my knowledge about music, then give some tips, not totally my ano, but ano lang.
Kasi di po ba, as teachers, as mentors, sometimes students, just like in any discipline in life, will actually be inspired or motivated by their mentors. So the responsibility is such a huge load on your shoulders.
Yes, it's a huge responsibility. What I do is encourage them. Mm-hmm. If they come up to me with an original composition, then I just try to check what is wrong with the composition and then let them work on it to make it better.
What about ethics in music? Is there such a thing as ethical issues also that they need to know?
Yes. Actually, in the choral world, ethics means not photocopying scores or pieces which were not given to you in the first place. Mm-hmm. That's one part.
What about originality?
Yes, originality also. You cannot just play the music of somebody else without permission.
So mahalaga, kailang alam mo kung kanino galing yun. At i-acknowledge mo yun.
Yes,
and don't claim it as yourself.
You cannot. You cannot.
But are these real things that you need to impart to the students?
Yes. Uh-huh. Because it's an issue already in the music industry. Especially with originality and then performing the work of somebody else without permission.
Mm-hmm.
So I have to tell them. And even the scores, you may photocopy for your file, but when you perform it, you have to ask permission.
Uh-huh. So kailangan mahalaga yon, knowing where and what and how to go about it. At ngayon naman po, we will be honored by a very simple rendition, no? Kahit hindi naman tapusin siguro, ng ating musically inclined and musically talented students of the College of Music under Teacher Anna. Please.
Oh. We are people, and we love to get connected. We connect as families because of birth. We connect as friends because we click. And we connect as communities because we care. Seventh-day Adventists are people who connect in communities called congregations, which in turn connect to form conferences, who connect together to form unions, divisions, and the General Conference. Why do we connect? It starts with a connection to the Creator, who invites us on a spiritual journey. When we journey together, we can help each other along the way. This journey is a journey of a lifetime. And as we learn and grow, life becomes filled with meaning and purpose. Our greatest joy is in helping others along the way. Wherever you are on your journey, we believe that we have something to offer that can make your life more whole. So the next time you see a Seventh-day Adventist, remember, you're not looking at someone who stands alone. They are connected to a world church that has 18 million members gathered in 13 divisions, comprised of 122 unions, formed by 600 conferences, serving in 140,000 congregations in 208 countries who worship in 924 languages, and they all want to connect with you.
We are strong.
to our episode here on the musicians, no, at Lourdes College. And again, I am joined here by Angie, our sociologist, and teacher Anna. And now, kanina Angie, narinig mo yung break natin. Ang ganda nung kanilang blending.
Yes, Doc. Sabi ni Teacher Anna, impromptu pa lang yun. Paano na lang kung may practice?
So diba? Ibig sabihin, we still look forward to better and bigger performances yes. from them. Mm-hmm. So how do you see it, yung ganito na napaka-passionate ng mga bata ito? Would it be better for them to, you know, as early as now, have a direction in their mindset, whether is it going to be a hobby or is it going to be a career thing for them? Before you answer that, I'd like to ask muna that question to our musically inclined students who are into music right now. So isa sa mga tanong ko, Nice, will Nice be the one answering here? How do you see music now for you? Is it going to be a career or a hobby for you? All right, whoever. Please stand and introduce your name.
My name is Miguel Masilungan. And I look music as a profession and a vocation. Profession, syempre we need to earn a living. Then vocation, by sharing it to the younger generations, imparting our musicianship, sharing our knowledge and experience to them.
Okay. What about sino ang gusto sumagot nito? How important, any of you can answer also, how important is it for you that you have that parental support and encouragement? Because you remember, it's going to be a challenge. Eh? So how important to you? How do you feel about it? Should your parents be all out in supporting you? Or paano na lang kung medyo nag-disagree ang mga magulang ninyo?
I'm Hazel, music student. It's a great factor if naa-jud ang parents because based from my experience, without my mom, I have no inspiration if I will play in a recital when I was still 15 years old, and that's for me.
Okay, and who else would like to answer this? Another musician there. What is your dream? Like, for example, 10, 20 years today, how do you envision yourself?
Christine. Hi, ma'am. I'm Christine. I'm taking up music. I'd like to see myself 10 years from now being a trainer in our church because I'd really love to impart my skills or talent that God has given me, because in the first place, I was sent to school to study music to help our church ministry. So yeah, I see myself as like training and involved in our music ministry. So that's
how many of you guys would want to be a concert pianist? Yeah. O kaya naman ala Lea Salonga? May I see a raise of hands? Ha? Hindi daw masamang mangarap. Yeah. Ayaw niyo ba? Ayaw itas ang inyong bandila? Wag mahiya. How many of you would want to see that? Alright, so congratulations. Ganun yun. Dapat kasi kailangan managinip tayo. Dahil without our dreams, there will be no driving force. So balikan ko, Miss Angie, yung tanong ko sa'yo. Hobby or career?
There is a challenge na kasi. Like, they're already in the academe. They're studying it already. Like, pursue it. Like, I appreciate those answers of the students. Magandang pagkaturo yung Teacher Anna, in fairness. Oo, kasi like, in the Philippine setting, I have stressed earlier, hindi ganun ka-lucrative ang business ng music. They see it as like, wala ka dyan. But then you have to understand, in our society nowadays, like music is all everywhere. Sa atin, part na siya ng daily lives natin. You just have your signature. Your own signature that's you, distinct, and make it appreciated by the general public.
In other words, huwag kang gagaya-gaya para yes. maging ano yes. ka lang, ordinary
yes.
na tao ka.
Oo.
So Teacher Anna, how do you define success in music? Is there such a thing as success in music?
Success in music means you can do whatever that is needed to be done as a musician. Uh-huh. If the role calls for you to train a choir or to conduct, you have to be able to do it. If the role calls for you to accompany a choir or a singer, you have to be able to do it.
In other words, napaka ano dapat ng isang musician. Kumbaga napaka flexible. Flexibility is the name of the game yes. here for you to stay on top. Eh, Miss Angie naman, paano yung mga magulang? What should be the role of parents who have children who would rather choose to be a musician rather than somebody else?
Parental support is very, very important. It's a general knowledge na siguro, understanding. Like, kasi yan yung interest ng mga bata. Like, even if it's not music, the parental support, that's the interest of the child. Like, I would encourage the parents to let the child blossom. Because otherwise, it would, sadly, some would result to failure. Worst case.
So yun yung sinasabi ng isang guest natin kanina, fly. They should have their wings to fly their own. Ano? So teacher Anna, are there challenges that, you know, these young musicians are going to face in the future? And what would your tips be for them?
The challenges is to keep up with the technology, actually. That's the challenge there. Because there are in technology now, you can arrange music through the computer. And to learn that, it's a bit difficult, especially if you don't have the inclination for technical things. And what can I say for them? Work harder. They can do. I told them, you have to be able to do whatever that is needed for a musician to do.
What about, Angie, for them to be able to, you know, rise to the challenges of the time, sinasabi ni Teacher Anna, what would your advice be to them?
Keep themselves abreast with what is the latest development. But at the same time, Teacher Anna mentioned kanina about yung ethics. Mm-hmm. Like this, we have the technology, it's also easy to copy. Yes. Kaya I stressed, you have to be very original, distinct. Dapat may signature that when they hear you, even what if you're playing an instrument or just or singing, I'm not gonna say just, sorry about that. Singing, there has to be a signature na siya yan. Like, Leia Salonga yan. Charis yan siya. Ganun.
So, may tatak sarili mo.
Yes.
And you have to develop and work on that.
Yes, practice, discipline. Yun siya. Kasi I'm a frustrated piano...
Student.
Okay.
Now, what about you, Teacher Anna? What is your vision? Like, for example, what legacy would you like to leave behind, say, yung students mo, sa college, sa music industry as a whole?
My legacy for my students would be they can do whatever I can do. If they are able to accomplish that, I'm the happiest person. Mm-hmm. Okay? Kasi there are a lot of things that they can do. They can do more than what they know now.
And they can even do better than
they
what we...
They can be better than me in terms of technology.
Yes. Wow. So admission from a great teacher. So I'd like to thank my guests, actually. What about you, Angie? What would you like, you know, your message to the young people, to the musicians?
Continue on. And please do not forget the Filipino culture because there's a greater, big challenge. I hope that our culture will be, makampaign pa siya. Sorry for the term. Yun siya. Like, kaya nga, we're celebrating OPM week this week.
Uh-huh. So, yun. Teacher Anna, your encouragement to the students and the viewers alike?
Continue with what you have started.
So,
it's
don't
not
give up.
Easy. Okay? The road is not smooth. But just be patient. Continue to work hard.
All right. And what about my partner here, Jovin?
Okay. To the viewers and to all who are here, ako lang iingon, music has been a part of oneself. So want to say to you today is that let's make music part of us, especially when we sing praises to our God. Because music is an expression on how we praise, how we love our God who is with us.
Okay, before I say my parting shot, I'd like to thank Lourdes College. Let's give a warm, you know, round of applause to Lourdes College, to the management. And, of course, to Mr. Chris Barcelona for facilitating all of this. Thank you very much for allowing Dynamic Youth to come to your school and be blessed by your students and your resource guests. And of course, dear listeners and watchers, remember this. Music can be used as a tool of blessing. It can be used to better another person's life and be a channel and instrument of hope and praise. Magandang araw po sa ating lahat.
The seed sown produces a harvest, and this in turn is sown. The harvest is multiplied. In our relation to others, this law holds true. Every act, every word, is a seed that will bear fruit. Every deed of thoughtful kindness, of obedience, or of self-denial will reproduce itself in others and through them instill others. This is the principle in action with the Integrated Evangelism Lifestyle Program.
Mas maayod siguro nga baka join sa care group. Parehan ako, gaan ang akong kanang huna-huna, gaan ang akong mga problema nga mabot sa ko pag maka-join kani ani maampuan mangudta sa care group.
Ipa-feel nimo nga part jud bitaw ang among family sa simbahan sa SDA.
Daghang kaayuhan, daghang answer sa prayer, daghang mga milagro, mga healing. Makita nila ang unsa day kalab ni Jesus ang katawhan sa Dios. Nadasig ko pag-ayo to attend or join gud sa care group family.
So, i-encourage na po, kitang tanan ng mga members sa atong church. Mubuhat ta kay, di naman madugay ang panahon.
With IEL, Adventist church members go out in clusters called care groups.
Every Seventh-day Adventist family to become a caring family.
These care groups are sowers in essence, going out, spreading seeds of compassion, sympathy, and love through visiting individuals and families, nurturing relationships, and enriching lives. The Lord says, "Blessed are ye that sow beside all waters." To sow beside all waters means a continual imparting of God's gifts. It means giving wherever the cause of God or the needs of humanity demand our aid.
Makapadasig kayo ni nga buhat kaning pagkuan pag-care sa mga pamilya labi na kanang lunay mga balatian kung amaganis lang awitan malipay sila nga bangay mahila
kana kung murag nag-backslide na katong uban pod nga dili pa mga Adventist ang bisitahan
nalipay ko nagamit ang talento sa pag-awit usa may mga Bible study magkanta
grabe jud kadasig sa mga grupo pag mo sa itabangan pag-ingon nga magkatins meeting tapilit tong kinanglan dali ra kay mag-gather ang kwarta.
Naami daghan nadala sa among pag-care sa mga ninoy-nay nga gawas sa among silang awitan gitukuran among silang balay.
daghan kayo mga challenges. Inspirasyon po sa mga kauban nga. Kung naluya na gani ang pangulo niya, dasig sa mga kauban. So, unang last yun ang tudaan yung time.
Ang buhat sa ginuligoy mauntang.
Pero ang nindot lang yun kay nakakatuon og humility. Forgiveness niya. Tamul nga doon ay conflict, tamul nga mo grow ang love.
Gibati na ko nga, nahimo nga part sa buluhaton sa Ginoo.
This method of sharing the message of hope in practical, modern ways hails from an age-old philosophy practiced by the revivalist himself, Jesus Christ. It is when we have touched a life and shared Christ's love and compassion that we have become arms to His ministry. And more than this is wrapped up in the sowing and the reaping. As we distribute God's temporal blessings, the evidence of our love and sympathy awakens in the receiver gratitude and thanksgiving to God. The soil of the heart is prepared to receive the seeds of spiritual truth, and he who ministers seed to the sower will cause the seed to germinate and bear fruit unto eternal life.
Grace sa iyong panalangin nga mugaday pa jud og daghang sud nga mga relasyon og daghang pa mga precious souls.